Message to Agnostics and Atheists. Thursday, November 18, 2010 at 9 p.m. To those who claim not to believe in me, I have this to say. Ask yourself this question: can you remember a time that you did? Think back to when you were a child, when you did believe in God. It does not matter what religion your parents followed. Did you believe? What changed? Was it influenced by others? Did they tell you that there was a rational answer to your being in existence? It has, since the beginning of time, been difficult for my children to accept any other existence outside of this one. Yet look around the world and see the wonders of the creation by my eternal Father. The sun, the moon, the sea, the rivers, the plants, the animals, and all the wonders of creation, and answer this. Where did all this come from? Do you really believe it emerged from something other than a superior being? Be warned when you hear the lies, spread by so-called fortune tellers, that exist in the New Age movement. They are being led into what they believe to be the truth and the excitement of the life promised to them in a new era. This era, to which they have been led to believe, is a new paradise, a form of man-controlled, but glorious center of the universe. It is a false doctrine. Many people of God, including those who believe, mistakenly confuse their belief in this doctrine with that of the light. They are being guided by the demons. Some know that they are. Others don't. Pray that they see the truth, before they continue on their futile path to emptiness. To the atheists, I say this. I love you no matter how you offend me. To the atheists, who are being led and influenced by other beliefs, stop and think. In their quest to follow man-made reasoning, they are simply believing in another faith. The belief that man is in control. He is not. Yet these same people, my precious children, for whom I will fight, are being encouraged to follow Satan, the deceiver, an enemy of mankind. Ask the atheist, who goes to extraordinary lengths to pressurize God's children, why he does this? Is it not enough to simply deny me? Why do these people lie? Many of these atheist groups have an agenda to entice and seduce my children into a false doctrine. Make no mistake, their belief is another form of religion, a religion that exalts the power of intelligence, reason, and pride. They emulate the very traits of Satan. They, in their blindness, follow another faith, the adulation of the dark, where no love exists. So passionate are these atheists, so proud of their religion, that they do not understand that what they stand for is a religion, the religion of the deceiver, who laughs at their stupidity. Atheists, hear me one last time. Turn back to the scriptures, now. Look at the book of John and consider the truth as it begins to unfold now. Does it not seem real to you, now, as your bare witness to events, as they are laid bare, layer by layer, each day, before you? Can't you see that my word, my prophecy, foretold so long ago, may be the truth? Open your eyes and talk to me, once, as follows. God, if you are the truth, reveal to me the sign of your love. Open my heart to receive guidance. If you exist, let me feel your love, so I can see the truth. Pray for me now. As I call on you, one last time, I say this. Love is not made by man. You cannot see it, but you can feel it. Love comes from the Eternal Father. It is a gift to mankind. It does not come from the darkness. The darkness that you feel is devoid of love. Without true love, you cannot feel. You cannot see the light. You cannot see any future. I am the light. I am the future. I bring you glory and life ever after. Turn, now, and ask for my help. Do that, and I will answer you and envelop you in my arms. My tears of joy will save you, as you become my beloved child, again. Come now and join me in paradise. your loving Savior, Jesus Christ.